ETCIO is a very prestigious platform. This is the second event that I'm attending, and the three things that I notice about this platform. First, the who's who of the industry is here. Every CIO, prestigious, big, small, they are here. So it's a great platform to network and speak with people. The second thing is, there are talks by CIOs as well as from our partners. And the talks by the CIOs give insights into the practical aspects of IT. And the sessions by our OEMs and our partners and the vendors, they give insights into what's coming and what how can IT leverage the latest and the greatest in technologies to help their digital transformation journey. So great crowd, great presentations, insights by the CIOs, and learning about new technologies. All in all, fantastic platform. There are quite a few, actually to name, there are five. There is AI, there is blockchain, there is AR, VR, there is 3D printing, and there is IoT. These are the five that come to my mind. Specifically in BFSI, IoT does not play such a huge role, but the others, whether it is blockchain, AI, 3D printing also does it. But AI, blockchain, and deep learning, these are things that are going to be the future in terms of technology. I have a slightly different view. I believe that the need for digital transformation and the need for technology is continuous. It's never going to end. We're just at a time where there are new technologies that are emerging, and 2 years down the line, there will be still new technologies emerging, and there will be new imperatives. At this point of time, we are focused on 5-6 things. First, for our digital business, we want to make it completely digital. A digital business should not be based on paper. It needs to be digital end to end. Only then the customers are going to feel that difference. The second thing is for our customers, we are a lending company, whether they want to know about our products or whether they want to subscribe to our products or whether they want to repay or they have a query that they want to resolve, the entire customer lifecycle will digitize and make it available on a mobile app as well as a portal, apart from our other channels. The third thing we are going to, as I just spoke in the session today, we're going to move away from waterfall and we're going to adopt more agile DevOps. Fourth, we're going to implement an architecture, we're calling it the liquid architecture. The reason it is called liquid architecture is because the IT architecture is going to take the shape of the business need. That's the nature of liquid. Instead of the business need taking the shape of the IT architecture, which are usually rigid. Our fifth initiative is around digitizing the enterprise. Most companies focus on digitizing for the customer. And what you would notice in these companies, while the customer is feeling the digital, but the employees themselves, when they join, they get a 21-page document to fill. So the enterprise itself is not digital. So digitizing the enterprise from within is our fifth. The next one deals with leveraging artificial intelligence and machine learning for intelligent algorithms and analytics. I think every part of the value chain of the business is going to benefit from AI and ML, and that's one of the keys. And while we do all of these, making digital, customer lifecycle, enterprise digitization, there's a very important aspect that we forget, and that is being reliable. So systems need to remain up, systems need to perform, systems need to scale, systems need to be secure, and systems need to respect privacy of customers, employees, and your partners. So we call that element being trustworthy, and that's our sixth element.